February 24, Monday of the seventh week in ordinary time. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. As Jesus came down from the mountain with Peter, James, and John, and approached the other disciples, they saw a large crowd around them and scribes arguing with them. Immediately on seeing him, the whole crowd was utterly amazed. They ran up to him and greeted him. He asked them, "What are you arguing about with them?" Someone from the crowd answered him, "Teacher, I have brought to you my son possessed by a mute spirit. Wherever it seized him, it throws him down. He foams at the mouth, grinds his teeth, and becomes rigid. I asked your disciples to drive it out, but they weren't able to do so." He said to them in reply, "O faithless generation, how long will I be with you? How long will I endure you? Bring him to me." They brought the boy to him, and when he saw him, the spirit immediately threw the boy into convulsion. As he fell to the ground, he began to roll around and foam at the mouth. Then he questioned his father, "How long has this been happening to him?" He replied, "Since childhood. It has often thrown him into fire and into water to kill him. But if you can do anything, have compassion on us and help us." Jesus said to him, "If you can, everything is possible to one who has faith." Then the boy's father cried out, "I do believe, help my unbelief." Jesus, on seeing a crowd rapidly gathering, rebuked the unclean spirit and said to it, "Mute and deaf spirit, I command you, come out of him and never enter him again." Shouting and throwing the boy into convulsion, it came out. He became like a corpse, which caused many to say, "He is dead." But Jesus took him by the hand, raised him, and he stood up. When he entered the house, his disciple asked him in private, "Why could we not drive it out?" He said to them, "This kind can only come out through prayer." The Gospel of the Lord. "I do believe, help my unbelief." This is a natural cry for help by a faith undergoing the pains of birth. The father's doubt stems from the disciples' inability to cure his son, which casts doubt on their teacher's power. He fears for his son's life, given the severity of the convulsion and the fact that human resources have already been exhausted. Jesus called for the kind of faith that rests on the certainty that everything is possible to one who has faith, a faith through which the believer entrusts everything to God. Only with such faith, Jesus indicates, can anyone experience miraculous power. This struggle to believe is aptly illustrated by Thomas Merton. Faith is not the suppression of doubt. It is the overcoming of doubt, and you overcome doubt by going through it. The man who has never experienced doubt is not a man of faith.